first you make sure it's down.
They're so hard to bring out.
Okay.
Yep, okay.
Then you take a coil. Remember we talked last week, you want good sized coils. You don't want to, that's good. And then you take a second, you could probably have a smaller coil. There you go. That's good, so it doesn't flap in your face.
Okay.
Okay, and then your third coil is like this, to reach up. Yep, you got it. And then you just start by chiming.
Yeah.
And then you pull harder. Actually, I can do it quickly. So then you pull harder and harder. Letting rope out. See how I'm letting rope out as I feel the tug? You let some rope out. And then see, I'm taking up some of my coil, keeping my hands together. And then just keeping the Sally out of my face. But when the Sally starts to bounce, you give it a little bit of a pull, so you're pulling on both strokes, and now the bell is actually up. So then you ring normally.
Then what?
Then you ring normally. So we'll take this down so somebody else can raise it.
I can do that.
Okay. You can do it. So the trick is to let, just you're going to need to just keep letting rope out. So as the bell goes higher, it's going to take up more rope. So you're going to just let a little bit out, but only kind of by the handful. Okay, so yeah, like that, exactly.
Yeah, but then look, then you get the
Then you let that one go. So that's why you have to have neat coils.
Straight down.
You'll get it.
Don't pull it in toward your body.
Right. Aiming for the hole in the floor.
The imagination.
Yes. Okay. That's how you keep the rope in front of you. Just aiming it down. Yep. That's good.
So the only purpose of the, you actually do pull off the Sally.
You do. But there's a point where the Sally doesn't have anything to pull, it's not high enough. So you just keep it in front of you. You're stabilizing it. That's right.
Right.
Nice.
Now it's just normal.
Now it's just normal, and he'll let go of his coil.
Yay. Well
done. You want to race?
This is going to be fine.
Great.
Hand, two hands. Mike.
Two hands.
Mike. You're doing fine. Let some rope out. There you go. Good.
Back towards your body.
Nice.
Straight down.
Straight down.
Beautiful. You. Nice job. Nice and smooth.
You
can probably let another handful out. There you go. Good. You're doing fine. you gotta.
Well, what do I need to do?
Let out a little more rope. And I'll just tuck. There you go. You're doing it now. Good. Okay, now one hand on the Sally if you can. Just touching it right for now. Yep, you got it. Really haul on the tail end.
What?
Really pull on the tail end. I know you are, but you're the, yeah, there you go. Good. Now let one hand, like one hand's worth, slip out of the tail end. There you go. Well, that's a little much.
You let out too much rope.
It's okay. Yep, that's right. Beautiful. There you go. You're doing it. You're almost there. Tug on the Sally if you can.
What?
Pull on the Sally.
Pull on the Sally. I'm just steady.
There you go. And right. Nice. Lose your last coil if you can. That's right. Now just ring.
You can ring.
Nice job.
Okay, I raised a bell.
You raised a bell. First time.
So if you're going on the sally, you can raise it faster than if you're just doing it on the backstroke.
Right, you get a little extra torque with each side.
One is down.
One is down. So
who wants to try one?
So when we say
who hasn't raised a bell yet?
Sarah
can raise
one. The bells are now literally standing straight up.
I lowered it again.
To ring them, you just give them a little tug.
Just for you.
And their momentum carries them around.
You can do it.
We were pulling right now to get them to stand straight up like this.
All right, Sarah. That was hard. I know. I don't know why.
It's hard to get that. Find the balance of letting out rope or letting out too much rope. So and you can only do it by trying it and doing it and repeating it.
So you have to pull hard, though.
You have to pull hard. You're getting 700 pounds from down to up. So yeah, that's work.
Okay.
It's not work when it's ringing, but so getting it from down to up.
But also the key is to really pull on the sally once you get to that stage.
Correct.
Right. So yeah. There's that fine point between when you're stabilizing it and when it has the ability to pull on.
That's right. That's right.
Okay.
So
you
overcome more inertia when you're pulling on both strokes.
All right, Sarah.
I don't know.
You can do it.
And you're just doing backstroke?
No, you're doing both, but you're only pulling on the tail end until the sally starts to bob. Okay, so you have coils, that's good. Nope, that's good. Reach all the way up now with your two coils. That's the way. And then just start pulling, and you have to let rope out as it goes up higher.
And I'm pulling really hard.
You're pulling hard. Use this as one chance where you get to pull really hard. Nope. You let out too much. There you go. Nice.
Pull straight down. Don't pull in and toward the butt.
Yeah, keep your hands together if you can. Beautiful. That's right. Right in front of you. Now let out a little more rope. You're going to let out rope pretty quickly on this bell because it's small. Good. Nice.
And now
with one hand, stabilize. There you go. But it's only going to, you're only going to keep it out of your face. Nice. Good. Yep, just a handful. That's right. Just a hand's width. You're fine. You are doing great.
All right.
Now pull us out.
Yep. You won't get much.
But
it's hard. Pull really hard at the tail end, though.
There you go. Oh, there you go.
There you go. I'm not feeling it.
That's okay. Okay, just stabilize it for now. Concentrate on pulling with two hands on the tail end. There you go. Good.
Pull on the sally. You're supporting on the sally.
It's hard to pull.
You are up. You did it.
You're up now.
Oh.
You're up. Wait, normally.
Oh, here
goes. Try to
lose on the sally when you can.
Yep, try to lose your coil. There you go, that's good.
Yay!
Right. Nice! Good form, you kept it. You were in control every minute.
You sort of feel like, I know.
A bit of a
I pull it too hard or something. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it's exact opposite of when you're ringing.
Right.
You have to just,
and
you don't have to pull so hard.
And getting tension on it is hard.
Yep.
It is.
Yeah, that's where the skill comes in. And that's just, you just do it from practice.
And that was the easiest one.
Right?
I gotta build up my muscles.
You're doing good.
Okay.
So all right. So are they all up?
Let's see.
Is five up?
Oh my gosh, I think so.
All right.
Wait a minute. Five's way up.
Five's not working today.
I know. But
I think this is your day.
Okay.
Which is your favorite?
I don't know.
Okay. And where were you? Were we working on backstroke or handstroke?
Both strokes.
Oh, you were in both strokes.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think she was ringing both strokes.
Oh, good. Oh, well.
Yeah.
Then
hop
in.
All right. As usual, I missed a week, so.
That's not a problem. Not a problem.
I'm going to do this style. This is my favorite.
That's your favorite? Then that's the one you should ring.
Yeah, I'll
you take them.
Okay.
No.
You want three?
Sure.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Your sunglasses might pop off.
Thank you.
Oh,
yeah. You don't want to do that. I don't want to do this. But. Okay, you remember what we do?
So they're all in the past. Well, first they did
backstroke.
Yep.
Right. And you know backstroke, forward and back.
I do.
Do you want to try it? Yeah, we'll do a few pulls.
Okay. So just go like that.
Yeah, and I'll carry. I'll do the Sally. Okay.
All right. So.
A little hard. Too hard. Too hard. Yep. There we go. It's a really little bell, and you're very strong. That's just right. It's amazing how little you have to exert, isn't it? Okay, enough of that.
So that's good.
Good. Moving on. So you reach up as high as you can, you pull down and let go, and the Sally will go up, comes back down on its way up, you grab it on the way up, and pull it down and let go again.
Okay, so up, let go,
yep.
Then it goes as it's on its way back up.
On its way back up.
Right, okay.
Exactly. You can do that. Hands down and don't look up.
Is it all right if Sean ran 7 or 8?
Sure. Yes, he should. There we go.
This takes more coordination.
Yep.
No, yep.
That's perfect. Right there. Okay. Yeah, because it doesn't quite bounce, but if you wanted to let it set, you could make it set. Absolutely. I'm multitasking. But you're good. This is great. You've got it. Yes, if you can set it.
So then, now.
Okay.
I got to combine the two.
You do. But you can do it. So, you always keep this in that hand. Okay, so you reach up with the rope. So you want all fingers around the rope. Then you pull the Sally down and you let go like you did, but you put this hand on the rope. On top. So. Yes, but do it in one motion. Don't do this. So, we'll play it again. Do this right there. Really important. Because it'll give you more control. And keep your rope intact. And it won't, it doesn't...
They join, then I gotta look for the Sally.
Once they join, you're gonna go up a backstroke. Then you're gonna pull it back down. And then you grab the Sally on the way up. So when you pull it down, you're going to let go with the right hand and then grab the Sally on the way up. I'm here. I am here. You can do it. All fingers are on the Sally. I know it's weird, but you'll feel better at the end of it. Good. There you go. Good. That's okay. It just means you're pulling. Don't look up. Two hands on the rope. Pull harder. I got it. Let go. It's okay. You were too low on the rope. That's way too high. There you go. Yeah, by the knot. That's a good thing. But that was all that was. I think that's. You just weren't able to get enough torque, so you weren't pulling hard enough. That's all. It's all by doing. You're doing great. All hands and then right to the tail end. So it's a fluid motion, so it should be, you know, boom, 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 boom. Okay? Easy for me to say. Nice. Good. Yes. It's fast, that's okay, just let it go up higher. There you go. So you let the Sally go up a little higher. Yep, you bounce, but that's okay. Yeah. So look at that, you slowed it down. Slowing it down means letting it go up higher. So it means, okay, I got it. Sometimes it's hard to talk and ring too, so. Yes. Yes.
Not just the sound.
Correct. So if you want the sally to go up higher, you have to grab it an inch lower. Only an inch. It's weird. It's those little... It's all very small measures when you, when you're actually ringing as opposed to raising. But you've got the, you've got it. Isn't it weird? Yeah. Yes, it's very, it's like day and night. Nice. That's fine. No, no. I got it. That's okay. Really stick with your spot on the rope. Okay? I think you slid up a little bit. I'm not sure, but I kind of saw you all over the rope. You know what? Let's just see how you do it backstroke. To see where you should be, okay? Can you set it at backstroke? Try to set it at backstroke, okay? You were close, so you need to be about an inch lower. That's all I'm trying to find out where you need to be. Because if you're shortening it, it won't go all the way up and the bell will start coming down. These are all the things.
It's different for each rope.
It's different from each rope, yeah. Because, yeah, some bells set deeper than others, and yeah, it's all very unscientific. They all have their own personality. Yeah, but you're doing great. I think so. All right. Right? You can do it. Nice. Good. Long, easy strokes. Beautiful. Nice. Congratulations. Now look where you are. You slid down the rope. Remember to hang onto that rope where you find the right position and hang onto it. Because it's, if you have too much slack, the bell will come down. If you don't have enough slack, the bell will come down. The bell always wants to come down. So you're... Yeah, because I didn't even notice. You don't, and I don't expect you to notice it right at the stage. That's what the next few lessons are about. We'll work on technique. But you are a bell ringer.
Yeah.
Bell whisperer, actually.
Bell whisperer.
No. You took to it like a duck to water. So go for it.
Very close
to setting. Nice. Pull harder. You're coming down a little bit. You're fine. You're back in the saddle. There you go. Pull hard. Oh. Okay, let go. Yep. Been there. Oh, yeah. Because if something breaks, your hand will get really hurt. So, you've got total control. It's just technique. Okay, you know what you're doing. So, bad form. Really bad form. You know, you can break a finger, you can, you know, not good. And you don't need to. Give yourself, some time. You'll get the technique down, and it'll be you'll learn how to raise the bell. When the bell starts coming down, I'll be here to help you, give you the pointers of how to pull it back up again. And part of that is pulling harder on the sally and the tail end.
When the bell is coming down,
yep.
It's going to
back. It's, yeah. So the bell, when the bell is up. Yeah. Where's our picture? We had a picture here. Up here.
I wanted to tell you that.
So when the bell is up, you see it's tipped back a little bit. So that's a set position. When the bell is actually ringing, it's a little further up. So this, it's straight up and down. What's happening is you're ringing it only to this level. So instead of 360 degrees, you should be ringing probably around 350 degrees. You're probably plumbing the depths of 340. So it's, you know, swinging just this, in this kind of an arc, as opposed to this kind of an arc. So, yeah. So that's why by pulling harder on each stroke, you pull it back up. Yeah.
She's on the
attack.
Oh, you don't need to. Just keep ringing. Oh, absolutely.
But anyway, she's a bad.
Do you want
to?
Stay on this one. This is your favorite. Okay. Now remember, you're a little low. There you go. You want that not above your, right above your thumb. I think that'll be good for you.
You've been a major player in this class.
If you'd like to, after the class, that'd be great. You can just grab me for like 4 minutes.
Yes, sirree. You got it. That's okay. Pull a little harder. Yep. Okay. I got the rope. Oop. See, you weren't too far down. What were you going to say? We all have one thing. I had a crabby old Englishman who yelled at me because I kept grabbing the sally like that. And he worked me and worked me and worked me and broke me of it. And I'm so grateful. Well, it's just not comfortable, and anytime it's any kind of pull on the rope is going to be this drag on the rope. So anything will bring the bell down. So what you want to do is keep a taut rope, which is mean not slipping down the rope, and long, slow pulls, steady pulls, keeping the rope in front of you. You got it.
So when it starts to get fast,
yes.
It just means I'm slipping.
Means you're slipping, so maybe...
I'm not pulling hard enough to pick it up.
Correct. So if you are slipping and you think you've slipped down the rope, choke up. And that will give you the torque that you need to pull the bell back up. Okay? Because you can't really... get a lot of leverage when you're too low on the rope. So that's just a threat. All these things to remember. Yeah.
Yeah. And look at a paper and write it down.
That's right.
I'm wondering why does
it keep grabbing you? Yeah. I think it's keeping your imagine there's a hole in the floor and you're pushing the rope through the hole. That's also one of the
position.
I think you are. You could, like, there you go. Maybe that'll help.
And all fingers then.
Yes, all fingers if you can. Nice. Good. Okay, choke up on the rope. There you go. Pull harder on the sally. Pull hard. Nope. Right in the middle. Don't look up. Pull really hard. Really hard. There you go. Hard. Really wail on it because it's coming down harder. Okay. Okay. you're sliding up and down the rope. That's just one thing you want to hang on to. Literally. And I think you're just not pulling hard enough on the sally. I think that might be part of the problem. You know, the amount you pull in one stroke affects the other one. So you want to find the balance of pulling both of them equally for this bell. Each bell has its own personality. Some bells are, the one Sean's ringing needs to pull much harder on backstroke than it does on handstroke. It's just the way it's built. Yeah, he's working. You've got a great bell and you know what you're doing. I'm here. Nice. Okay. Nice. Good follow through. Right. Hang on. Okay, it's all yours. Pull really hard at backstroke. There we go. Nice. You can set it at some point, but you have to pull hard. Really hard. Nope. Close. Close. You're fine. You want to get back control. That's fine. Yes. But you got it back under control. That's the trick. It's really just a matter of technique. You know how to rein. You won't be pulling this hard in the future because you'll find the right balance of the only way to find the right balance is to do it. So you'll find the right balance of how hard to pull on each stroke. And the other thing, the other trick is technique. Is one of the things I've noticed is that you have a floating right hand, so you let go of the sally and you keep it down here, and you grab the tail end on the way up. So you're losing leverage. You're basically ringing with one hand. And immediately grab the tail end. Every ringer has that problem, so it's fine. It's all a matter of just getting the technique down. And when you get both ends of the technique, you'll be able to ring any bell in the tower. So, let me give you a breather, and I'll show you how to do the rope. So the reason we tie the ropes this way is so that, well, I'll show you at the end, but so you fold it in half.
Try to avoid that mouth.
Yep. And then you put it to the right of the rope. stick your thumb out. That's right. No, you had it right.
Right, I think I have to block that.
Yep, there you go. Now reach around and grab this part of the rope and bring it over. Bring it around the top and then... No, I got it wrong. Oh, you have to bring it around the loop, that's why. And then over the loop. And then, yeah, now I think you can let go. We'll see if that works. It doesn't. All right, let's try it again. Fold it in half. This is the hard. It's easier to learn to ring than it is to do the rope. So you stick your thumb in there, and then I usually flick it back. Now reach around. Yep, that's it. Man, what am I doing? So you reach around. You bring it over the loop.
Yep.
It should be there. Let's see what's. You're not getting it on here. Let me just. So, you flip it around so that the loop is here, then you reach around, bring it around the rope, and then around the loop. And the reason for that is that if the bell just goes off, well, it'll come out.
Yeah.
That'll be your homework.
I need practice for sure.
Oh, it's the heart. No, you got it. Now stick it here. And then flip this toward you. Other side. Yep, and then reach around and grab this part. And then over the loop. That's it. There you go. Now you're a full-fledged family. Nice work.
Thank you.
Nice work. We'll get you back. Oh, we'll get you on another bell in a few minutes. Breathe.
Yeah. So exciting.
It's great.
But it's not a bell number. It's not a bell number.
Where are we?
We want to try and ring in rounds.
Brave.
Well, we just thought, what the heck? Why not?
Do you know the words?
Well, I'm learning. Look two.
Yep.
Treble going.
Yep.
She's gone.
Very good.
Right?
Yep. And we say she's gone as you pull.
As I pull.
Yep.
All right, ready? Look two.
Oh, we're going to ring four?
Treble going. She's gone.
Too slow, is it? Okay. So, just follow Signy.
Am I too fast? Nice work!
Going. And what did we learn on this one? That the guy with the heavy bell is the one who sets the pace.
Yeah.
So we kept saying it's too slow because he was trying to keep that bell.
Because your bell wants to go faster.
It does.
So you need to keep your momentum going.
Right.
And I was actually.
I wanted you to get a good workout today.
Right.
So is it much harder to ring like 1 and 8 together than it would be to ring 3 and 4?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Because
absolutely.
Of that.
And when you're ringing all 10, the treble bell basically sets at every stroke, practically. Mm-hmm. So the smaller bells have to ring smaller because of the arc of their
size. Much faster because they're smaller to keep up with the bells.
Yeah, because the wheel and the bells is all proportional. Right. Yeah, so it's that's why you follow the tenor. But you knew what you were doing. You were following Jason.
Well, and then Jason stopped on you.
And then Jason stopped, so you followed Sydney.
Why did Riley follow
me? Let's go. You were doing fine. Oh, you had it. Excellent. There you go.
All
right. Isn't it funny how the knot is the hardest thing?
Oh, I know.
Nice.
Great job.
All right. I saw you over there. You're doing great. Yeah, this is wonderful.
You didn't
forget. It's like riding a bicycle, right? As they say. So what's next?
Jeff, did you see music? And that's why you came? It was beautiful.
Okay, who has? Has everybody had a chance to ring?
I think so.
Okay.
I think so.
Nice. All right, well then maybe just more.
More ringing.
All right. All right. What's for me?
She's flattered.
Yeah.
He's my
husband's now.
It's a
timing. Oh, hello, Louise. How are you? Yeah, hi. Dan Cooking. Nice to see you.
Dan.
Nice to see you. Oh, good. Scary. Very scary. Be very, very afraid. You did good? Nice. All right, what are we doing? What do we have? We have the front four or the back four? Do we want to ring the back four? Okay, so they wanted to ring and then they ran away. Where do you want to be? You have your choice. So what are we doing? 1, 2, 3, 4. So you can have either one of these. How's that? Okay. Where's Martha? We're going to ring the back four. Just to show off. Which one do you want? The lighter of the two? Okay. All right. Yeah. Is it okay if he moves this?
Yeah.
Okay.
Crazy.
So we'll give you a sense. So this way you'll hear all the bells.
Okay, ready? Rounds on the back.
Otherwise, I think we should ring Ben.
You have to know. Trouble going. She's gone.
Only four or five good rounds there, I think.
We did it, absolutely.
Quail's gone, she's gone.
Over a ton.
Wow. Right? So 3,000?
Yeah, about 2,000 pounds. Yeah. Smooth, isn't it? Yeah, it's like
a short blast of 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh, you're not the best. Michael wants a bigger.
I know, bigger and better.
Wait a minute. So when you say short blast, you mean one ring and stand?
No.
We're
going to
do two minutes. You're 3 minutes.
2 minutes of.
All right.
Eight bells.
Now, how many we got?
So you're doing the middle three?
Seven bells. What's that?
Oh, we're doing all seven?
Huh?
Oh.
We're going to ring it.
I see. I know that tactic is to stall. That's a stalling tactic.
That was a good tactic. You saw through it.
All right, here we go.
Okay. Well, it's going. She's going.
And maybe you should ring a little bit too, and then we can. Want to try a different bell?
Sure, yeah.
Live it up. Actually, yeah, we'll put you on.
Oh, you need these up?
Yeah.
Okay, so you probably need to be lower on this. Here, let me see. I'm just going to ring it. No, you need to be low. See where I am in the room? I'm close to the knot.
We're not bringing the next Tuesday, on next Saturday, right? We're not.
After winning the tenor, I think this is. There we go. It's a very shallow set of hand stroke. But that's fine. So you're probably going to want to be right near the knot.
Right, so you say Saturday, Monday?
But wait.
I hope that I can do it. I will make it. What time?
Good. Follow through. There you go. Good. Good. A little different, isn't it? You've got control though. You stopped that. Yeah, it's got a little bit going to it, but pull hard. Really hard. There you go. Good. Hard. Yep, really hard on the salad. There you go. Don't look up. The temptation is so hard. Beautiful. Good job. Try to set it when you can. But follow through. Nice. She's a shallow set. Oh, you were so close. Follow through. Nice. Pull hard. Good. Give it all you got. There you go. All right, all yours. There you go. It's okay. Pull hard. All yours. What do you mean you can't set her? Nice job. Yeah, you were having too much fun.
That was awesome.
You did great.
Well, thank you. And that's the hard bell.
So this is the first, it is a hard bell, and this is the first time you've done both strokes. So you are, you are doing great.
Thank you.
You set the bell.
Dan, nice. Dan has a way of making
I know.
Nice. Thank you.
Well, you guys are doing great.
Thank you.
Did you get it?
You are one more.
Transfer, do you want to try again?
You're a fabulous teacher.
Oh, thank you.
One more.
Which, have we rung this bell yet?
No.
Go ahead.
Here, we'll go up there.
Give us a little. So this is the lightest bell. I don't think we've heard this today.
Oh, no, I did this one.
She rang.
Oh, you did? Oh, she did. All right. Okay. Okay. We will put you on the. All right. Put you on two. And then we'll take them down.
Sure.
Do we want to do, have students take them down? Yeah, just trying to.
Yeah, we leave the back four up and
bring a little, and then why don't you just take it down when you're, how's that?
No, that one stays up.
Okay.
That one stays up, that's six.
Yeah, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Nice, you don't have to pull that hard. It's a really little bell. It's all, there you go, it's all about technique. Long, easy pulls. Good. Yep, a little harder. There you go. Nice. Oh. The peanut gallery. You have a fan club.
I want her to look good. Oh, she does it.
Well. Technique. Sally. There you go. With you in a while, so nice work. Have you ever taken a bell down? No. Would you like to? They do it by themselves. All you have to do is keep the rope. Okay, so what's going to happen, I'll show you on this rope, is you're going to ring normally, and you're just not going to pull so hard. But you're going to keep control of your rope, so you keep the rope in front of you, so it's all about keeping control of the rope. And then as you get slack in your rope, you take a coil, maybe like that. Okay, so keep the rope slack, but you want to keep both hands on the tail end. And then as you feel the rope tugging on you, you add a little more. So feed your coil till it's about that big. And then keep letting a little bit of rope out. And then you take another one and you feed that one as you inch. Basically, you're inching your way up the rope, keeping it under control. That's really all you're doing.
And the goal is to just get it to stop.
Correct. Correct. You're trying to take the belt. So you're taking the belt from the mouth up position to the mouth down, using its own weight, basically, the inertia. Yeah.
And three now.
Nice. And the good thing about ringing down is you don't have to pull hard. You stop and, well, there you go. Yep, take your coil. There you go. One hand on the Sally now. I'm sorry, I didn't tell you that. Okay, you don't even have to pull it. Just keep it out of your face. Take another coil. It goes fast. Yep. It's okay. I got the Sally. You just take your coil. There you go. Beautiful. Try to keep both hands together on the rope. But take a coil. You gotta be higher. And that part will come with time. Nice. Now you can hear it sound when you're pulling. Keep doing that. Keep jerking it when it goes up, when it's over your head. Stop it like stop it short. That's it. Now keep going. Yep. You could do that all day. You can just keep chiming. All you're doing is the clapper is still moving and you're stopping the bell and the clapper hits against it. So it's just ding, ding every time you stop the bell. Every time you jerk on the rope, it stops the bell. The clapper keeps moving. It's called chiming. You did it! Hey! And the first time you take a bell down, it's like, it's a mess. But actually, you did very well. But yeah, the coils are always one of those things. When do I take it? You just do it. You learn by doing.
Yeah,
absolutely. Nice work. Who else hasn't taken a bell down? Sarah?
No, that was awesome.
Did she do great?
Yeah. That one needs to come down.
It's us.
Sarah.
Excuses. Yeah, you're doing. It's going to come down fast because it's 500 pounds. You're keeping tension and also keeping the rope out of your face. But you don't, yes, as you're going. You're coiling with one, well, you coil, but you keep your hands on the tail end, yeah. Yeah. But you only work on this, you've lowered it out, right? Oh, I'm sorry. Oh! Okay, yeah, so you start by ringing, just ringing, and then you don't pull as much. Okay, so the bell starts coming down on its own. You take a coil as the rope gets slack, and then you feed the coil. So basically you're ringing like this, and then you're adding a little bit in there. See how I added a little bit? Just really, it's only 2 inches or an inch. And then as this starts getting clapping, you kind of work your hand up, and then you take another one, and then you feed that one, and feed that one, and feed that one, and see where I am? I'm up on the Sally, so that's...
I'm never being good.
You will know what it is. Not my strength. This looks very out of control. That's
it's, well, what you're trying to, basically you're controlling chaos, because the bell is coming down. It's in the upside down position, bring it to the mouth down position. So you're reach higher when you pull. There you go. So just bring it for a couple of seconds. There you go. Nice. Okay. Yep, you can just, you don't have to pull on the Sally now, just keep it. Yep. Good. Got just two hands on the tail end now. You don't need to, yep. You don't need to worry about the Sally anymore. It's not going to do you any good. Keep your hands together if you can. So inch your way up with both hands. Just gives you more control.
We need to get shoulder.
Good. Excellent.
This is going to come out shaky.
Inch yourself up onto the Sally. There you go. And when it goes up, jerk it, just chime it.
It seems like a couple people speak, two or three mics.
Keep doing it.
Very good. Thanks for
having me. There you go. You did a great job. That's a hard bell to bring down because it goes so fast. Nicely done.
I want to thank the big bell. It's impressive how all that power behind that.
Right? Oh, now it comes down beautifully. Yeah.
We'll
have you do that sometime.
I don't think so. I need special gloves.
Then it'll be like, it'll really kind
of
explain.
We have a picture of somebody else's bell. But that's what it looks like now. The tenor bell looks like this. And when we pull on the rope is attached to the wheel, and it turns the bell. And the bell, with its own weight, swings in a full circle, 360 degrees. And then you pull it again on the back, the tail end of the rope, and it swings around back. And that's what we're wanting to do is get the hand-eye coordination, and the only way you know where the bell is feeling tension in the rope. So it's learning to understand the tension in the rope that makes it such a challenge. It doesn't take a lot of strength, it just needs to, it's about control and technique. You see, I probably heard me yelling, pull harder, pull harder. The bell will, its instinct is to come down, so you're trying to overcome its own inertia. And keep it up, keep the bell in the upward position. So that's what the technique is about. But at the end of this class, none of them will have to pull as hard as they were pulling. So that's the neat thing about it. Good job. Nice to see you. Nice to meet you.
All right, guys. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you.
Bye.
Good work.